What is going on, guys? It is your boy DFastX, and I'm back with another movie review, and this is my review on Talk To Me. Forward to the video. If you're new here to some more exciting videos and new to this channel, smash the subscribe button, tap the icon, and drop the likes. Let's start right to it. So I didn't see this film in the cinema, so I watched this on DVD, and I also got to say, guys, I absolutely enjoyed this movie. Talk To Me has been one of the best films I've seen this year. Guys, I gotta say, I was impressed with Talk To Me. And not as much of a horror guy, I don't watch horror films, but this was a really, really good movie. So, what the story is about, it's a story about this group of friends who are communicating with the dead. Not fun, right? who else does that, you know? They communicate not by a Ouija board, but they communicate with this kind of stone hand. And when they hold the hand, they say the words, "Talk to me." And then in their vision, they can see that person right in front of them. And then they kind of let the spirit, let them get inside their body, which is really, really creepy. And but things turn into a terrible twist, because what happens is, I'm not going to say much of it, but things go wrong. I'll just say that things go wrong in this movie, which I like about horror films. When you mess with spirits, all that stuff, things take a terrifying turn. Because things happen, crap happens, so it's... I was left shocked when I was watching this film. Like, I was like, my reaction was like, oh my good lord. That was one of the best films that I've seen. One of the best horror films that I've ever watched. You know, it was really, really well done story, I gotta say. There's a girl called Mia, played by Sophie Willer. I forget her story now, but she played a character called Mia. And Mia kind of went too far on herself, tried to, you know, communicate. Because apparently she was able to communicate with her mum, who apparently died in this movie. And things don't turn out the well, Jiva, because her mother tells her in her head that about her father going on and stuff, and there's a little plot twist of what Mia does to her father. I'm not going to say much about it, you have to watch it yourself, but I just got to say, it doesn't end well. It does not end well with Mia and her father in this movie. But It's not even a long movie. It's about 91 minutes. It's only like an hour and a half movie. So it won't take it. It won't be as long. Like, it's only a short feature film. Like, so, I thought this was a really good movie. You know, it's really worth watching. If you're looking for a horror film to watch for Halloween or whatever, or just a proper Halloween, this is a good movie to watch. This is a really, really good movie. And even myself, even after watching this movie, I might actually watch this again, because, you know, it's actually a really, really good story. And, you know, it's so bad, like, I missed this in the cinema. I live in the countryside. I live outside the city and stuff, all that. Or, like, I don't live near the city. If I lived in the city, I could just walk down to the cinema and just see what any good movies are on. Because I really would love to see this in the cinema. Same with Gran Turismo back in August as well. But unfortunately, I just couldn't do it. But rest of the story, it's really brutal. Really, really brutal. But the ending... The ending of this movie, oh god, the ending is so good, because it doesn't, I just want to say this, that something happens to Mia. That's all I'm going to say. Something does happen to Mia, but you have to find out yourself in this movie, because it is really, really good. Overall, guys, I really enjoyed this movie, and I think I should start watching some few more horror films, and I've seen some I really like. The Ring franchise, not great. They're terrible movies. But I'm gonna try to see by the new year I'm gonna try to get into the horror franchise and stuff, because I've been avoiding that for so long now that I must actually start getting into these kind of horror films after I watched this now. But overall, guys, I'm giving this an 8 out of 10, 4 stars. It's on DVD right now, or on digital, it's also on Netflix as well. Go watch it. It is a really, really good horror film, and it's something to watch on Halloween as well. And in my opinion, I'm gonna watch this again sometime. You know, it's just so good. It's really, really good. I'm gonna put that in a ranking list of 2023. So that's my review of Talk To Me. So that wraps up all of 2023 films. It has been a great year for films. And now, unfortunately, I couldn't get to see Aquaman, The Lost Kingdom, and Ferrari. But I hope maybe to upload my reviews sometime in January or later on in the year next year. But I'll be back for my official video of entering 2024 on my official movie ranking, my official TV show ranking. So stay tuned for more of my videos, guys. Smash the subscribe button, click the bell icon, drop a likes, and I'll see you next time. Peace.